is at a higher level.
Oh, that's right.
Than the one that struggle with sin.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
Self-mastery keeps me from looking at the sin of anybody else.
That's right.
It keeps me from focusing on anybody else's wrong.
That's right.
For me to master self, I must bring, and Brother Paul said, I must bring myself under subjection, lest I be a castaway.
Castaway. That's right.
Are you getting me?
But I keep under my body.
Hear this.
1 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 27.
I keep
under my body.
I keep under my temple.
That's right.
My tabernacle, my earthly house.
That's right.
And
bring it.
And bring it.
Into subjection.
I bring it. I have to bring my house under subjection.
That's
my temple under subjection.
That's right.
Because my body, my temple, my house is a member of the body of Christ.
That's right.
And if my body, my temple, my tabernacle, my house get out of place, then it affects me being a lively stone.
That's right.
You see, you got to have a stone mason when you're building a building.
Oh, yes.
Then you got to have a master mason. In other words, he knows the craft.
That's right.
A stone better than the stone mason.
That's right.
Because the stone mason may put the stone in.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have an inspector who come by looking at the stones.
That's right.
Looking at the plumb line, making sure there is no bow
right
in the wall. So either he or the one that put the stone in, he may get a hammer,
mm-hmm,
gently tap it, because it's protruding out too much.
That's right.
When you're in sin, some of your character protrudes.
That's right.
Which is a clear manifestation of your sinful conduct, your sinful life.
That's right.
Like a false prophet.
Mm-hmm.
His lies protrudes.
Oh, yeah.
It shows itself.
Oh, yes.
That he is a product of bad teaching.
That's right.
And by him being a product of bad teaching, the followers of falsehood become products also of bad teaching.
That's right.
So the sin that is justified in man-made churches, it protrudes. Show itself.
Oh, yes.
And it's necessary that we take the Bible, beat it.
Beat it.
Back in place.
That's right.
Until the hammer of the word of God beat it right out of you.
That's right.
It is not the will of nobody to submit to someone taking a hammer and beating you across your head.
No way.
You're going to dodge and scream and run, but the word is called a hammer.
Is not my word like as a fire?
Here, Jeremiah.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 29.
Is not
my word like as a fire?
Hold it. God is going to describe His word. Different ways.
That's right.
Is not my word
like as a fire?
The reason why it's like a fire, because it comforts you and it consumes you.
Oh, yeah.
It comforts you in the time of trouble, and that same word come to consume everything that is of us.
That's right.
That is not of him.
That's right.
What else?
Is not my word like as a fire, saith the Lord,
and
like a hammer.
Wait a minute.
Amen.
It's like a hammer that does what?
That breaketh the rock in pieces.
You know you're stubborn like a rock.
Like a rock.
And this is why sin flourishes.
Oh, yeah.
In false churches, nobody is swinging a hammer.
That's right.
The Baptist preacher, the Methodist, the non-denominational, the Catholic, the Protestant, and all that man-made religion that come out of hell. It ain't nobody using a hammer.
No, no.
What do you mean? The word is not being preached.
That's right.
Because if it was being preached, they wouldn't be of none of those religions, no way.
That's right.
So the word come like a hammer.
Like a hammer.
And you got to have a preacher that's not afraid to use that hammer.
That's right.
And God knows, brother, I'm not scared to swing the hammer.
Amen.
Not at all. And if I hit you with the hammer of the Bible, I ain't gonna check and see what damage you've done either. If you've been damaged, you might as well just look to the Lord for healing. Because whatever is in me before the Lord come for me to escape hell, I'd rather for God to take the wrecking ball of the scriptures and wreck me good.
That's right. That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
So a hammer is used for the church.
Oh, yes.
To crush everything in us.
That's right.
That is not like God, so we can master God's will.
That's it.
Go back to Thessalonians. Everybody all right?
Back in 2 Thessalonians 2 and verse 2.
Follow me.
That ye be not so soon shaken in mind.
Be stable.
Stable.
And?
Or be troubled.
Don't be troubled.
Neither by spirit, nor by word.
What else?
Nor by letter as from us.
Yeah.
As that the day of Christ is at hand.
And?
Let no man deceive you by any means.
Do you hear that? That's what got me barking against false prophets. That message last night, people are raging on social media. there's many hundreds that are thankful, but there are many upset, mad.
Mad.
Angry. They're angry because they're guilty.
Yeah.
They can't get me to change, and that upsets them.
That's right.
Because I tell the world, I cannot be bought by nobody.
That's right.
You can't offer me, glory to God. You can't offer me absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
You can't offer me nothing. Imagine offering me something.
Oh, Lord.
And you compare it to what God have already offered me.
That's right.
I turn you down quicker than I can spit.
Amen.
Nobody's offer rivals God offer.
No way.
Are you listening to what I'm telling you?
That's right.
And you, the human family, have to love God enough that you choose Him.
That's it.
Above everything else.
That's right.
Are you getting me?
That's right.
The Holy Book says what?
Let no man deceive you by any means.
Don't let nobody deceive you. Don't be deceived by the celebrities, the fake Christian celebrities out there.
That's right.
Don't be deceived by them.
That's right.
You know, because they got over there, they commented on social media, look at all them women. Mm. Nobody wearing makeup? Mm. Nobody wearing makeup? That's disgusting. Wow. Now, if a celebrity came out and said, I'm going to go natural.
Right.
I'm not going to perm my hair. I am not going to wear no fake eyelashes. I am not going to wear no lipstick, no makeup. I'm going to go natural.
Yeah.
She'll be on TMZ.
That's right.
She'll make headline news.
That's right.
And millions of women around the world say, you know what? I'm going to embrace the way God made me. Right then, they bring God in.
That's right.
I'm going to embrace the way God made me, and I am going natural.
Natural. Amen.
You know why they're so shocked not to see no makeup wearing women?
Mm-hmm.
Because they're so used to Jezebel.
That's right.
And when you've been raised in a Jezebelian atmosphere, that's all you know.
That's all you know.
When you've been raised dressing half naked, that's all you know.
That's right.
Here we come with the Bible. One man said, man, it ain't none of them women that I can lust at because I can't see nothing. Praise the Lord. Yeah.
That's right.
Glory to God.
That's right.
Amen. That's where it's supposed to be.
That's where it's supposed to be.
Don't you know the Lord Himself made coats of skin
and
clothed Adam and Eve in the beginning?
That's right.
God's people are supposed to be clothed. You out there in public, I don't care how hot it is, the Bible don't change for men or women.
No.
You out there, God says be clothed.
Oh, that's right.
That the shame of your nakedness do not appear.
I counseled thee to buy of me.
Do you hear this?
Revelation chapter 3 and at verse 18.
Have you noticed? You don't get this fight out of Muslim women.
No. No, you don't.
No, the Muslim women will cover themselves if it's 100 degrees.
That's right.
And church so-called Christians will look at them and say, "Ooh, how can they wear that? How is it you can't?"
That's right. That's true.
It's something about being a sinner.
Amen.
That all of us are guilty of.
Yeah.
But we don't like to be told about our sins, but you still want to be this Christian.
That's right.
How can you pull that off? If you want to be Christ-like,
oh, yes.
There's a book here.
Oh, yes.
We call the Bible, but this book call it the Scriptures.
That's right.
B-I-B-L-E. Some said basic instructions before leaving earth.
Yeah.
I like better biblical instructions That's before right. leaving earth.
Right.
Because these biblical instructions exceed basic instructions that somebody will give you.
Oh, yes.
Are you listening?
That's right.
So he want to give you biblical instructions before you die.
That's right. That's right.
And these instructions going to come from the word of the Lord.
That's right.
Look at the very heading of the book. The word of God.
Word
the
of
word of God, God. Not the word of men.
No.
That means God himself. And you viewers who get mad at me and all I bring you is the word of God. They fighting me bitterly for them two and three wives. And one man wrote, one man comment, I smoke, I go to bed smoking. I don't see nothing wrong with it. You won't see nothing wrong with it until the doctor give you three more days.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Am I right, I said? When the doctor tells you you got three more days or three more months, right then you want to become a Christian.
That's right.
As long as you got your health acting like a fool.
Oh, yeah.
Then you said you don't see nothing wrong with it.
Nothing wrong with it.
The term Christian meaning Christ-like. Christ-like is a lifestyle.
That's right.
It's bigger than coming to church. Anybody can come to church. Roaches come to church.
Oh, yeah.
Come to church more than you and make babies in church.
That's right.
It's a lifestyle. When you look at the scriptures, Jesus, who was God manifested in the flesh, he taught his apostles all the same thing.
That's right.
Peter didn't go out being the first pope like the Catholics lied.
No.
Paul didn't start Protestant. Matthew didn't start Lutheran.
No.
John wasn't a bad, none of that stuff.
None of that. None of that.
He gave them all the same thing.
Same thing.
And sent them all out to preach the same thing.
That's right.
You that are here in Washington, D.C. and the world, do you know you should be able to go into every church and hear one message?
One message.
Just one?
That's right.
Just search the scriptures.
That's right.
You didn't have Baptist, Methodist, Presbyterian, and Lutheran. Don't go tell me John the Baptist, his religion wasn't Baptist.
No.
If his religion was Baptist, then that means he would be in trouble. Because John said, I'm not the light.
The light.
I am not the light, but I come to bear witness of the light.
Of the light.
John said, one come after me, he's mightier than I. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost. Thank God, and that with fire.
With fire.
Come on, son.
2 Thessalonians 2, we're at verse 3.
Yes.
Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come.
Listen at this.
That day shall not come.
The coming of the Lord is not going to come yet until.
Except there come a falling away first.
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 There's going to be a mass backsliding.
That's right.
Men and women.
That's right.
Preachers. So-called bishops, elders, prophets, deacons,
That's right.
mothers, them that believe in sanctification,
That's
holy.
Right. That's right.
Many of them are going to turn their back on God. Amen. It's already happening.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's hard to find now a holy church.
That's right.
But it's easy to find a church that's nothing but a club.
Yeah.
Do you hear this?
Let no man deceive you by any means.
Glory to God.
For that day shall not come.
That day shall not come.
Except there come a falling away first.
Now, that means this. The Bible said, if you build up again, give me that.
Yes.
The things you destroy. You make yourself a transgressor. You that is in these apostolic churches and non-denominational Pentecostals in D.C. and the state of Maryland and the world, I want to show you the signs of the falling away.
That's right.
The falling away is when you got a preacher that was strict.
Yeah.
And believe in strictness in the church.
That's right.
He was adamant about living holy, living right, and putting God first. Telling the people that God's way is right. Let's do it like the scripture says.
That's right.
But then his work start to swell. People start to come in.
Yeah.
Crowd get bigger. So now things that the church used to did not allow.
Right.
He preached against Christmas.
Yeah.
Because there is no Bible that says Jesus was born December 21st. Ain't 25th. Ain't no Bible said that, you old liar.
No.
And he stood firm on it.
That's
but
right.
Then when the crowd got bigger, now Christmas parties in church.
That's right.
He preached the truth that there is no Bible that says Jesus rose on Easter. And it isn't.
No.
You pagan hypocrite.
That's right.
He stood on that. But then when the crowd got larger,
yeah.
Easter egg hunts for the children.
Oh, yeah.
He stood on the scripture of 1 Timothy 2:12 when Paul said, I suffer not a woman to teach.
Mm-hmm.
Nor the use of authority over the man, but to be in silence with all subjection. No women preachers.
Right.
Crowd got larger.
Oh, yeah.
Now women evangelists, women pastors, women assistant pastors, deaconess.
That's right.
He stood on the scripture that if a woman pray or prophesy, having her head uncovered, dishonor her head, and he had knowledge enough to know that was not talking about her hair.
Her hair.
Oh, so wait a minute, Pastor Jennings. In that same chapter, it says her long hair is a covering. Let's read that.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
In case I got any United Pentecostal folks here.
That's right.
And PAW folks here.
That's right.
Amen. I want to tie you with Bible and show you what the Bible is saying.
That's it.
Listen.
1 Corinthians chapter 11, we'll start at verse 5.
Follow me.
But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered.
Her head uncovered.
Dishonoreth her head.
Now who would be that dumb to think that Paul was talking about putting hair on.
Hair on.
Or having hair off.
That's right.
Only wig wearers do this.
That's right. That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
You know, especially many of you old folk that got them different color wigs in your cedar closet.
Wigs.
Protected by mothballs.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, wigs with salt and pepper, and they're blending with their outfit, and then got another wig. She's about 80 with silver eyebrows, but I got a cold black Indian wig.
That's right.
Amen. Little girl, only 15-year-old, she wearing wigs now.
Yeah.
Amen. Everything is in the wigs. Nobody don't want to be the way God made them.
That's right.
You just want to be fake all around.
All around.
Fake lips, fake hips, fake breasts, fake hair, fake everything.
That's
fake
right.
Fingernails. Fingernails so long you can't even pick up a phone good.
That's true.
This is what the churches have become.
But every woman that prays
that
or prays prophesies
with her head uncovered. With her head uncovered.
Dishonoreth her head.
Dishonor her head. And remember, the head of every woman is the man.
Is the man.
Uh-huh.
For that is even all as if she was shaved.
Now, if you pray or prophesy, which means worship.
Worship.
Worship God with your head uncovered. God look at that through the apostle as if you shaved your head.
For if the woman be not covered.
If the woman be not covered.
Let her also be shorn.
Let her also be shorn.
But if it be a shame.
If it be a shame.
For a woman to be shorn or shaven.
If it be a shame.
Shame.
For a woman to be shorn or shaven.
Let her be covered.
Then let her be covered.
And now at verse 10.
The word covered means complete.
That's right.
Now look at the verse that these so-called apostolics and Pentecostals go to
First
to justify women in church bareheaded with nothing on their head. Listen at this. I want to show you how ignorant they are.
1 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 15.
What is it?
But if a woman have long hair,
it's
a glory to her. For her hair is given her. For a covering.
Hold it.
That's right.
Covering and covered and uncovered are three different words.
That's right.
Uncovered. Bare. Covered, complete.
Right.
Covering, incomplete.
That's right.
What do you mean? Just say if when the Lord bless us with a building down here, and brothers are laying carpet, some of the folks come in, what y'all doing, Pastor Jennings? We are covering floor.
That's right.
Covering. The floor. No need to ask, are we finished? Because it's not complete.
That's right.
We are covering. That means the floor is in the process of being covered.
Covered.
Are you getting the old man?
That's right.
So long as we lay in that carpet, we are covering.
Covering.
So your hair is a covering.
It's a covering.
But you're not complete covered.
Covered. That's right.
Are you getting me?
That's right.
It's a covering for your head.
That's right.
But now you have to cover.
Covered.
And to cover, you have to cover your covering.
That's right. That's right.
Are you getting me?
That's right.
Glory to God.
But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth.
What?
With her head uncovered.
With her head uncovered. That means bareheaded. You mothers, you know you got little girls.
Yeah.
And in the wintertime come, it's snow and it's cold out there. You tell her, girl, don't you go out there bareheaded. You didn't tell her put hair on.
No.
She got hair. You just did her ponytails, for goodness sake.
That's right.
Don't you go out there with nothing on your head. It's cold.
Cold.
So you grab your daughter and put that ski cap on, them earmuffs, and wrap that scarf around her mouth. Oh, you got her all covered.
All covered.
So there's a difference between covered and covering.
That's
and these
right.
dumb bishops. Read this scripture and say, well, you see, your hair is what cover you. You ain't got to worry about that because your hair is your covering. No, covering means incomplete.
That's right.
And when you're incomplete, now you got to be covered.
Covered.
Amen.
That's right.
I just want to straighten that out as I go.
That's right.
So when the things that the preachers used to stud for, now when the crowd get larger, they start becoming unbelievers of what they used to believe.
That's right.
Everything they tear down, they build up.
In the book of Galatians chapter 2 and at verse 18.
Says what?
For if I build again.
Do you hear this?
Amen.
If I build again the
things which I destroy.
I make myself
a transgressor.
A sinner.
That's it.
Any bishop build up any wrong.
That's it.
And tell the people it's all right to do it, and yet the word of God is against it.
Amen.
He build up that wrong that he used to be against. He's a sinner.
I make myself a transgressor.
You have made yourself a sinner.
That's right. That's right.
Your preaching's good. Glory to God.
Amen.
When you had a small crowd of about 25 or 30 people, you preached against remarried and divorced.
Yeah.
Because there wasn't enough women in the church for you to flirt with.
That's right.
Am I right?
That's right.
Then all of a sudden, more women come in and the crowd get larger. All of a sudden, he got a revelation.
Oh, yeah.
He got a revelation now.
That's right.
That he can divorce his wife.
Oh, yeah.
So he can get another. Or he will have so many couples in there with second wives and second husbands who are big financial contributors. He don't want to hurt their feelings.
That's right.
So each one may come to Bishop. Bishop, I got my second wife, you know, and I know it's wrong. And Bishop, by the time he get that influx of adulterous relationships, he going to tell each one, look, it doesn't matter.
That's what
it doesn't
saying.
Matter. Were you saved when you got the second wife? Oh, no. Oh, okay. Well, if you wasn't saved, then you done it when you was a sinner, then you all right.
You all right.
Adultery can be committed by a sinner or a saint.
Or a saint. That's right. That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
So this is what the preachers have said in the Apostolic and Pentecostal.
Mm-hmm.
If You got your adulterous husband or wife.
Or wife.
Before you got saved.
Yeah.
Or, no, no, if you got married when you was a sinner.
Yeah.
And didn't get saved. You can divorce the sinner husband or the sinner wife.
Or the sinner wife.
And get you a saved husband.
Yeah.
Or say what? It ain't no Bible gave you that permission.
No, no,
now,
no.
Now this is what the Bible says.
In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 7. And we'll start at verse 7.
Listen at this.
For I would that all men were even as I myself.
Wait a minute. Apostle Paul, the apostle of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
He wasn't married.
No, he wasn't.
And he said, I would you was like I am.
I would that all men.
What he saying? He said he wished you were single. But the difference between Paul and single men today, Paul lived right.
That's right.
Am I right, I said?
That's right.
Paul ain't fornicated since God saved him.
That's right.
He did all his fornication before he got saved.
Before he got saved.
Because he told you. In time past, give me Titus chapter 3 real fast.
Verse 3.
And begin at verse 3, I want to show you Paul's lifestyle.
That's right.
Before he waked up.
Titus chapter 3 and verse 3.
Read fast.
For we ourselves also were sometimes
foolish.
Look
at him, reflecting on his past.
That's right.
We ourselves were.
Sometimes foolish.
We were foolish.
Disobedient.
We were hard-headed.
Deceived.
Tricked.
Serving divers lusts. And
serving
pleasures.
Diverse, all
lusts.
Kind of lusts.
And pleasures.
And he had pleasure while he was doing it.
Living in malice and envy.
Hateful.
And hating one another.
But then what happened?
After that. The kindness and love of God our
kindness.
Savior.
Kindness. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
And love of
and
God our Savior.
And the love of God our Savior.
Toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness.
It didn't come because we were so good.
Which we have done.
But what?
But according to his mercy he saved us.
Wait a minute. What did he do?
But according to his mercy, he saved us.
How did he do that?
By the washing of regeneration.
When you've been washed by regeneration, you got the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. And what else?
And renewing of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, got the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues.
That's right.
So the Apostle Paul told the church of Corinth, I would, brethren.
I would that all men were
that
even
all
as I myself.
Men.
All men.
Was even.
As I myself.
Like myself. This goes to show you don't have to be married to be a preacher.
That's right.
But if you are married,
that's right.
You only can have one wife.
One wife.
I say if you are married.
Yes.
Give me 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1, son. Come on now.
Amen.
I want to show you this. Amen. Just in case many of you that may be undercover preachers here.
That's right.
Preachers on the down low.
That's right.
Don't want folks to know that you are some kind of preacher.
Right.
And you may have your second wife. In fact, you left her home because she didn't want to come because she know I preach against adultery. Amen. But when you go home to your adulterous wife and sleep with your adulterous wife and have your adulterous children and you are an adulterous bishop, you go to your adulterous church and you're going to an adulterous hell.
Go ahead, man.
Get me now.
1 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 and 2.
What is it?
This is a true saying.
Wait. Anything else opposite from this is a lie.
This is a true saying.
This is the truth here.
If a man desire the office of a bishop.
If a man want to be a bishop.
He desireth a good work.
What is his qualification if he want?
A bishop then must be blameless.
What else?
The husband of one wife.
Right then that condemn women preachers.
That's right.
Go on and say, how's that, Pastor Jennings?
That's right.
It said the husband of one wife. It didn't say be the wife of one husband.
No. The husband of one wife.
So, woman, how are you a bishop?
Amen.
How are you a bishop?
How are you?
How are you an apostle?
That's
how
right.
are you a pastor? How are you an evangelist? How are you an elder?
That's right.
Don't go bring me Philip, four daughters, and say they were evangelists, you old liar.
No.
Bible talked about how they were
prophets.
And prophesying is not preaching.
That's right.
Prophesying is the foretelling of an event that's going to come by God's permission, and that's given to a woman that's a prophetess and a man that's a prophet.
That's right.
That's not breaking down the scriptures, opening them up and taking it apart.
No.
Huh?
This is a true saying.
This is true here.
If a man desire the office of a bishop.
If a man desire the office of a bishop, he desire a good work.
A bishop then must be blameless.
You got to be blameless.
The husband of one wife.
All right, if you are a preacher, how many wives you got to have?
One wife.
How many?
One wife. One wife.
One.
Any
preacher in the building tonight or this afternoon got more than one, you's a sinner.
That's a sinner.
Did you hear me?
That's right.
I don't care if you got a cross around your neck big as the White House.
That's right. That's a mighty big
Until
cross.
Until they got to put you on a flatbed truck every time you wear it.
That's right.
If you're a preacher this afternoon and you preacher. Got a second wife, you're a sinner.
The husband of one wife.
What?
The husband of one wife.
Even Jesus got one wife.
One wife.
I want to say, Jesus got one wife? Yes!
That's right.
And his wife is the church.
The church.
The church is the bride.
That's right.
And he don't have two churches, he got one.
One church.
Jesus said, upon this rock, I'll build my church.
My church.
Glory to God.
Amen.
And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it.
This is a true saying.
This is a true saying.
If any man desire the office of a bishop.
You desire the office of a bishop.
He desireth a good work.
What?
A bishop then must be blameless.
Blameless.
The husband.
Of how many?
Of one wife.
That's all, buddy.
That's all, buddy.
Glory to God.
That's right.
So if there's any preachers that are watching and listening, I don't care who you are. You can cuss, get mad, jump, fall out, go in a coma for a year and come back.
Go in a coma.
The next year, this scripture's still going to be here.
The husband of one wife.
So many of these preachers out here that's supposed to be apostolic or Pentecostal stood on these principles.
Yeah.
Speaking in tongue without it, no Holy Ghost.
Without it, that's right.
They told the people, you got to have it like they did on the day of Pentecost.
That's right.
Later on, everything changed.
That's right.
You can't even recognize the churches now that you are members of.
That's true.
Can't recognize them. Amen. You don't know whether you're still in the club that you was at Saturday night.
Amen.
Because that's what your church looked like now.
Yeah.
I was watching the message this morning from last night. And you know on YouTube they have in the corner other things.
Mm-hmm.
And they had something that came up. I'm like, what in the world is this? They had Kirk Franklin.
Oh, my Lord.
Just dancing like the world, which I expect him to do because he's a sinner.
That's right.
And then they had this other fella that's supposed to be in a preacher. I cannot remember his name. He had on a blue suit with big rhinestones and wore lime green woman heels.
What?
Up in the pulpit, he must had about 6-inch heels.
My Lord.
A grown man supposed to be a preacher and the crowd was right there.
My Lord, my Lord. They have put no difference.
What?
Between the holy and profane.
Do you hear this?
In the book,
in
of,
the
Ezekiel,
book of Ezekiel.
Chapter 22 and verse 26.
This is where the churches are now.
That's right. They are putting no difference.
Give chapter and verse again.
Ezekiel chapter 22 at verse 26.
A grown man, lime green heels.
My
Society
Lord.
Is so spiritually doped up.
That's right.
Doped up with the wickedness of Satan.
That's right.
The attitude of the so-called church people across the board today, when it comes to sin, it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
That's right.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. They look at a preacher walk around. If I, like I said last night, if I came in here with booty shorts, somebody would say, it doesn't matter.
That's right. That's true, Pastor.
Amen.
That's right.
They'd say, it doesn't matter. It
doesn't matter.
Some will still listen.
Yes,
some are still dumb enough to listen to me.
That's right.
But them that got good sense, oh, the man lost his mind.
That's
Let's
right.
get out of here. Let's run.
Let's run.
Next song they sang, run! And don't look back.
That's right.
The devil is causing this great falling away.
Falling away.
Which shows us this, more will be lost.
Oh, yes.
Give me the Old Testament.
Yes.
Only a few will be saved.
That's right.
It ain't a mega church on social media that's telling the people how to live holy. Not one.
That's right.
Noel Jones ain't doing it. T.D. Jakes, you know he ain't doing it. Creflo Dollar, he ain't doing it. Kenneth Copeland, they're not doing it.
They're not interested
in going back with God by paying a Bible price.
That's right. Not interested.
Their only interest is give you this illusion of heaven on earth.
That's it.
And this earth is not heaven.
No.
Glory to God, heaven and earth is going to pass away.
That's right.
And the lust thereof. But he that do the will of God shall abide forever.
In the book of 2 Esdras chapter 8.
Listen at this. In 2 Esdras.
Chapter 8.
Chapter 8.
And at verse 1.
Verse 1.
And he answered me saying, the Most High hath made this world for many.
Listen at this.
Amen. The Most High.
That's God.
That's God.
The Most High.
Hath made this world for many.
He made this world.
For many.
For many.
But the world to come for few.
The world to come for few.
At verse 3.
Says what?
There be many created.
There be many that are created.
But few shall be saved. Many created.
Why such a few?
Many created.
How many things did Adam do to get put out the garden?
One.
How many?
One.
If you got one sin on you, you can't enter into the kingdom of God.
That's right.
Somebody say what? Fifth chapter of the book of Ephesians, son, real quick.
That's it.
Follow me. Stay ahead of me and get me. He gonna present
unto himself.
Give chapter and verse.
In Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 27.
This is why there's such a great falling away. If you take note, New Jerusalem, whom John saw coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. John said, the city lieth foursquare. The length, the breadth, and the height thereof are equal. He said, there's 12 foundations, and the name of the 12 apostles was on the gates. And he said, one part of the city is 12,000 furlongs, and another part is 144 cubits. New Jerusalem have never been enlarged.
That's right.
Never went through renovations. Never been changed in size.
That's right.
It is designed to hold a number that no man can number, but in God's eyes, that number is still a few.
Still a few.
But because there's so many.
That's right.
Going to hell.
Therefore, hell hath enlarged itself.
God made hell bigger.
That's right.
Do you hear the Bible
in
talking?
In Isaiah chapter 5 and verse 14.
Isaiah 5:14 says,
Therefore,
hell
hath enlarged herself.
Have gotten enlarged.
And opened her mouth without measure.
What?
And opened her mouth without measure.
No measure?
Without measure.
New Jerusalem is measured.
That's right. That's right.
But hell?
Without measure.
No measure.
And their glory and their multitude and their pomp, and he that rejoiceth shall descend into it.
It's so many.
That's right.
Until the number of those that are lost.
That's right.
Exceed those that will be saved.
Those that will be saved.
In the book, because there will be sinners who will never come to God. I don't care what you tell them.
That's true.
You got that.
That's right.
John said, he that is holy, let him be holy still.
Let him be holy still.
He that is righteous, glory to God, let him be righteous still.
That's right.
He that is foolish,
let him be foolish.
Let him be foolish still.
He that is unjust.
Do you hear this?
In the book of Revelation chapter 22 and verse 11.
He that is unjust.
Let him be unjust still.
Let him be unjust still.
And he which is filthy.
He that is filthy.
Let him be filthy still.
Let him be filthy still.
And he that is righteous.
He that is righteous.
Let him be righteous still.
Let him be righteous still.
And he that is holy.
He that is holy.
Let him be holy still.
Let him be holy still.
And behold, I come quickly.
What?
And behold, I come quickly.
Here he comes.
And my reward is with me. Hallelujah.
Now, it is that last statement that people forgot.
Forgot.
He said,
Behold, I come quickly.
I'm coming quick.
Quickly.
But
and my reward,
is with me. Hold it right there. Because there's two rewards.
That's right.
There's a reward for the holy. And there's a reward for the wicked.
For the wicked.
The reward for the holy. Blessed is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such the second death have no power.
No power.
The reward for the wicked is hell.
Hell. That's right. That's right.
Hell was enlarged.
Enlarged.
Without measure.
Hell hath enlarged herself.
Because there will be more lost.
Oh, yes.
Then saved.
That's right.
Sinners who never will come to God.
Right.
Even after they hear the word of God, they won't come. Some of them.
Some of them.
And then you have those that came.
That's right.
That will commit treason.
Yeah.
And turn their back on the Most High.
That's right.
That will blend in and enlarge hell. Those that's going to hell.
Therefore, hell hath enlarged herself.
I'm determined not to be included there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
Living holy may be hard.
Yeah.
Because you got to give up a lot.
That's right.
Everything you love that's against God, you got to give it up.
Oh, yes.
You don't feel like doing it. Glory to God.
No.
You don't want to do it.
I want to do it.
Yeah, but my fear for hell.
That's it.
Caused me to plead with God to help me do it.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
That's it.
Huh?
That's right.
My fear.
That's right.
Glory to God for hell.
That's it.
Caused me to pull on heaven.
That's right.
And ask God to help me to overcome.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Build me up where I'm torn down.
That's right.
Do you understand?
That's right.
Glory be to God.
That's right. For if I build again,
the
things which I destroy, I make myself a transgressor. Hallelujah.
Many of you watching now, you once was baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And have the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues.
That's right.
Striving to live a holy, sanctified life, sister. You was doing fine until you met that fella.
That's right.
That fella pulled you right out the church.
That's right.
He hypocrited and came to church by your invitation.
Yeah.
Clapping and standing up, bobbing his head to a false prophet you invite him to hear.
That's right.
He even went as far as getting baptized. He got on his knees and spit all over the chair.
My Lord,
pretend
my Lord.
Pretend like he was speaking in some tongue.
That's right. That's right.
You thought that was God's gift for heaven.
Oh, yes.
You married him.
Married him.
He came to church for a few months. Slowly but surely, he starts staying home more, more.
That's right.
More. You came home and found cigarette butts in your house.
Yeah.
Now cans of beer in your house. Everything he tore down, slowly but surely, he built it up.
If I build again the things which I destroy.
How do you expect to come out of anything when you're hanging around a crowd that's doing what you're trying to stop doing?
That's right.
The Lord says, come out.
Come out from,
among them.
And be ye separate.
And be separate.
Saith the Lord.
Are you listening?
That's right.
So slowly but surely, he start to coerce her.
Yeah.
Because he missed the life they used to have, clubbing.
That's right.
Or she miss the life she used to have, partying.
That's right.
So she dig her friends back up on social media. Mm-hmm. Social media is good and bad.
And bad.
Social media, man, I'll send you to hell quick.
Oh, yes.
Make you hunt down them old girlfriends and them old trifling boyfriends.
That's right.
Make you look up strangers.
That's right.
You don't even know his name or her name.
Amen.
Then you go meet them. Amen. And then nobody can find you.
That's right. Be not deceived.
Do you hear?
1 Corinthians 14 and verse 33.
Don't be tricked.
1 Corinthians 15 and verse 33.
Chapter and verse again, Will.
1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 33.
Yes.
Be not deceived.
Don't you be tricked.
Evil communication.
Evil communication, what does it do?
Corrupt good manners.
Hold it. Evil communication corrupt good manners. Good. Let me miss this example. If you come from a good structure family, mother and father was there, they laid good groundwork.
That's right.
Raised the children right, God-fearing, told them no sex before marriage, none of that.
That's right.
Laid down a clean law. Don't you come in this house, no 1 and 2 and 3 in the morning.
Amen. Amen.
Good structure. Then they start hanging around the wrong crowd. The crowd is only successful in manipulating you, man or woman. And that's determined on how weak you are.
That's right.
If you're weak, you can be easily manipulated.
Oh, yeah.
If you're not weak, the devil can come out of hell. You're going to remain firm and solid.
That's right.
That's but so many of our young people are being lowered back.
Oh, yes.
They didn't wait to get steadfast.
No.
Some run and get married because they don't want to fornicate. That is not a reason to marry.
No.
You're married because you love that man or love that woman.
That's right.
You see, when you're single, you have to strive for mastery, so you got to be disciplined.
Discipline.
You got to strive for God to discipline mind, soul, body, and spirit.
That's right.
That's why the Bible says you're killed all the day long. Yeah. I ain't never seen a dead person get up and kiss nobody.
No.
Now, here's God tell us, he said, you're dead.
You are dead.
And your life is hid with Christ in God.
That's right.
And this is why holiness is so firm. It come to kill the living. What you mean? Living in sin so I can be dead in Christ.
That's right.
Glory be to God.
Be not deceived.
Man.
That's right.
Don't be tricked.
Evil communication.
Evil.
Evil communication.
Thanks be unto God communication.
Corrupt good manners.
What it look like a bunch of young people spending the night over a single sister house, brothers and sisters. What's
brothers,
the matter with you?
And sisters.
A bunch of young people.
That's right.
Bunch of sisters spending the night over a single brother house, brothers spending the night over a single sister house.
No.
Come on, well, we all holy together. You're a bunch of hypocrites and heathens.
That's right. That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
I don't care who you are.
Amen.
There ain't no single sister should be spending the night over some single brother house or some brother spending the night over a single sister house. I don't care if it's 500 of you. You want to spend the night, go home.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
Are you listening?
Be not deceived.
I know we're all a bunch of single sisters going to be in a single brother house. And they're like, well, we all in prayer. How? In nightgowns and slippers, in drawers, in pajamas.
That won't be lasting too long, Pastor. That's right. That's right.
That's the devil out of hell.
Amen. Amen.
There ain't no single sister should be getting her suitcase packed to go spend the night over some brother's house.
No way.
And that ain't your husband?
No.
Because other sisters gonna be there? It ain't no sister supposed to be there.
That's right. That's right.
Speaking in tongue, Jezebel. Are you listening to the old troublemaker?
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Are you getting me? What did the Holy Book say?
Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 1.
Amen. There was one amen came out so like somebody was whining. Amen.
That's right.
I ain't got that thing sound painful, didn't it? Glory to God. All right, come on, son.
1 Corinthians chapter 7, and we're at verse 1.
Yeah.
Now, concerning the things whereof you wrote unto me.
What is it?
It is good for a man not to touch a woman.
Only the Lord said that, not Paul.
No, Paul.
Paul told you the way he used to be. That's he served divers lusts.
And pleasures.
And pleasure. I mean, he had fun.
That's right. That's right.
Divers mean all kind.
That's it.
Man, here come God changed that man.
Now concerning
and
the
and now
things,
made him say something he would never say.
That's right.
Concerning the things
whereof
you
wrote,
unto me.
It is good for a man not to touch a woman.
It ain't no man going to say that unless God get a hold of him.
That's right. The only way.
Am I right, man?
Yeah.
Talk back to me.
Yeah.
That's the only way.
Ain't no real man going to say that.
No man.
Unless God get a hold to him.
That's right.
And even when God got a hold to him, he may got trouble saying that.
Oh, yeah.
But he got to tell the truth of it.
Amen.
Glory Amen. Be to God.
Amen.
What did he say?
Now, concerning the things whereof you wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to touch a woman.
Yeah, that's what the Bible says. That's what the scripture says.
That's the scripture.
We wouldn't say it.
No. No way.
We wouldn't say that.
Uh-uh.
And let the Holy Ghost get a hold of you, then you have to say amen.
That's right.
But what did he say?
Nevertheless, to avoid fornication.
To avoid
fornication.
Sinning.
Let
to avoid unlawful sex.
That's right.
What did he say?
Let every man have his own wife.
Get your own.
And let every woman have her own husband. Her own.
And some of you got married and may say, well, we didn't have no sex. You know, a lot of churches teach if you get married but didn't have no sex yet, you didn't consummate the marriage. You're not really bound. You bound the moment you got that license.
That's it.
Amen. I don't care if he can't move and she can't move. When you got that license, that's your contract.
That's your contract.
You bound.
Bound.
Amen. If you married him and he in the freezer, you bound to that popsicle. Yeah.
That's right.
You bound, buddy.
That's it.
That's Amen.
Right. That's right.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm telling you?
Amen.
You're bound, I said.
Nevertheless, to avoid fornication.
To avoid it.
Let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own
husband. Ain't no church sleepover.
No, it's not.
Amen. Not here.
No.
I better not find out you're having one. I come in there like Jesus and turn your tables over. Yes, I will.
That's right.
Bunch of young single people talking about sleeping over. Sleeping over what?
My Lord.
All these brothers there and sisters there.
Mm.
Somebody gonna wake up 2 o'clock in the morning.
Yes, they will.
They got their cold, they got a cold knock. And she knows it's him.
That's it.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
Hurry up.
Not so loud. Mother Gretel is next door.
That's right.
Not here.
No.
Dang fellowship, that's folly.
Folly. Behold, he putteth no trust in his saints.
And I don't either.
That's right.
Give chapter and verse.
Job chapter 15 and verse 15.
Ain't no single people got no business crammed in one house spending the night, brothers and sisters. If you all brothers, fine.
Fine.
All sisters, fine.
That's right.
Together spend the night, no.
No, no.
You don't need no revelation. You ain't stupid.
That's right.
In the world, you sitting around all comfortable in nightgowns and panties and bloomers and bras and no girdles. And he's sitting around in drawers and jockey straps.
Go ahead.
Talking about we having prayer meeting. He all jumping around in jockey. Yeah. He all on to some spirit.
Right, Lord.
It's some spirit with jockey straps.
Right, Lord.
Am I right?
Yes, that's right.
You know I'm telling the truth.
That's right.
Glory be to God. That's the devil out of hell. God knows it is.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
You see, I got thousands of young people. I got to pound
got
this.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
You want to come together, have a cookout? Fine.
That's fine.
But you that have these cookouts, don't you have these sisters leaving your home? I don't care if it's brothers and sisters, if it's 100 of you. No sister should be leaving out of your house from a cookout the next morning.
No way.
Shut that stuff down and tell them, all right, it's That's almost right. 12 midnight, time to go.
Time to go.
You got to go.
That's right.
Bible said in all things you've done how?
Decently and in order. All things.
Not leaving your house the next day.
Next day. That's right.
Amen. Are you listening?
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
This is old-fashioned holiness.
Oh, yes.
And this is what the people have fell away from.
Fell away from.
The great falling away is they fell away from holy sanctified teaching, and That's now it. The world have leaped to their own understanding.
That's it.
What did he say?
Behold, he putteth no trust.
Yeah, chapter and verse. This is Job 15, 15.
Job chapter 15 and verse 15.
The Lord talking.
Behold, he putteth no trust.
He said he don't put no trust in his saints.
In his saints.
That meaning his God don't trust his people.
His people.
What do you mean? He don't trust their flesh.
No.
He don't, no matter how much Holy Ghost they got, he know they still flesh.
That's right.
And that flesh act up sometimes.
That's right.
And that's why you got to have a preacher to pound on that old wild stuff.
Wow.
You're a wild thing.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Amen. Yeah, some folks, they feel like they're caged in. My God, man, they're about to explode. They are wild things.
Wild things.
Amen. Come on, son.
They only put no trust in his saints.
Come on and say, well, if they're that wild, why don't they get married? Listen, you got the most naive concept to think marriage tames everybody.
Right.
Marriage do not tame everybody.
No.
For some people, marriage made them worse.
That's right.
Because they're not getting what they want at home.
That's right.
Well, that's another subject for another day. All right, come on, Williams.
The Holy Spirit has no trust in his saints.
He put no trust, I said.
In his saints.
Glory be to God.
Yea, the heavens are not clean in his sight.
If the heavens are not clean in his sight, that means heaven is dirty in his eyes.
How much more abominable
is what?
And filthy is man.
Look how God look at man.
How much more abominable and filthy is man.
That's why you need to be born again. Your nature is dirty.
Dirty.
Your nature is dirty.
That's right.
You need to be born again. You got a dirty nature. You're liable to go back
That's
to
right.
where God brought you from.
Oh, yeah.
You're liable to go right back to it.
Right
Don't
back.
You feel your flesh being pulled sometime?
Oh, yeah.
Am I right, Isaac?
That's right. That's right.
That's why it shocked a lot of people how so many men come in this. These men know this old sugar mess won't help them in the church they're in.
No way.
You got some old sugar watered down fairy for a bishop who don't bother your sins.
That's right.
You see, when I came from the hood, I often meet this example. From the hood, there was two ways of boxing. Slap, body. You like to go to churches where your preacher deal with sin like this.
That's right.
We come along.
Mighty close, Pastor.
Eh? That's what we come along.
That's right.
Old Testament and New Testament.
That's right.
I haven't hit you yet out of all these years.
No, you haven't.
Not yet. Glory to God.
Amen.
So, when the will of the flesh start to activate again.
Oh, yes.
You need to be around preaching
That's right.
that deals with that troubled body.
That's right.
And that troubled mind.
That's right.
Because it's a form of bringing the mind and body back on track.
Back on track.
It's the same thing when you got a car. Yeah. You hit too many potholes, too many bumps.
Oh, yeah.
You need an alignment. Am I right?
That's right.
And you can tell that you need an alignment by the way your car drives. You can tell when your body, your life, your temple is out of line, with God's word.
That's right.
So you need a spiritual alignment so you can walk right again, think right again.
That's right.
Talk right again.
That's it.
And be like God wants you to be.
That's right.
Got to have an alignment.
Alignment.
And this old religious trash, it don't align your wheels.
No.
In fact, it mess up your hinges and everything else.
That's right.
It give your whole flat tire.
Amen.
Come on, son. Let's go back to Thessalonians
back
real
second
quick.
Second Thessalonians, chapter 2 and verse 3.
Yes.
Let no man deceive you by any means.
Don't let nobody trick you in any means.
For that day shall not come.
That what?
Except there come a falling away first.
And
that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition.
Now, to fall away from God, you can't fall away from what you've never been a part of.
That's right.
Many of you that are watching around the world, throughout America and Canada and Africa and Europe, certainly have abandoned God. Many, not all. Some is hanging on by the skin of their teeth.
That's true.
Some of the church organizations that had a little decency.
Yeah.
They done took that and threw it out the window and exchanged it for prosperity preaching.
That's right.
There are preachers, like many apostolic organizations, Bible Way Worldwide, who headquarters are here in D.C., former bishop, Bishop Smallwood Williams, who passed away. He was starched against divorce and remarriage. Starched against it. And he was against women preachers.
Amen.
He used to be the general secretary for under Bishop R.C. Lawson. Before he died, the women preachers was coming in the different Bible Way temples and the remarriage and divorce. After he died, it exploded.